Namaskar, hello and welcome once again to NCRT's live phone-in program. In this maths class for all the 9th standard students, we're going to discuss the topic lines and angles. And this is the second part of the same topic title. If you have not seen the first part, I would request you to please go to our YouTube channel NCERT Official, and the first part has been uploaded there already. Because these two parts are linked, so it'll be much better if you watch the first part as well as the second part. So we have an expert with us. Let's meet her. She is Miss Usha Pillai. Welcome, ma'am.
Yes, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Ma'am is from Campion School, Bhopal, and she'll be answering all your questions. If you have any doubts, any queries, please feel free to mail them on our email ID, which is dth.class9@ciet.nic.in. You're watching us live on PME Vidya, channel number 9. If you want to know the details of our scheduled programs, please visit our website CIET and Swayam Prabha. There you will get all the details of the information, our schedule, our timetable, everything. So let's begin today's topic, lines and angles. But because this is the second part, let's ask ma'am that what exactly did we learn in the first part, and then what are we going to learn in this second part? Over to you, ma'am.
Good afternoon, students. In the last class, we already studied about lines and angles, different types of lines and different types of angles. In different types of lines, we have studied about parallel lines, perpendicular lines, intersecting lines, concurrent lines, etc. So you know, if two lines intersect at a point, we can say the lines are intersecting lines. If they intersect at 90 degree, they are perpendicular lines. And the lines which passes through the same point are called concurrent lines. Now next, we have studied about parallel lines. Lines which do not intersect are called the parallel lines. So you know, here we have already studied about parallel lines on the last session. That is, here AB parallel to CD is given, and the distance between these two lines at each point are same. Now, continuation of these parallel lines, we can study about the properties related to the angles made by a transversal when it intersects two parallel lines. So what are these properties? You are already studied this in 7th class, but the continuation of that is given here in 9th class. So first we have to understand what is a transversal. A line which intersects two or more lines at distinct points are called transversal. But when we are asking, so many of you are telling, a line which intersects two or more parallel lines, it is called a transversal. Parallel lines also, this line can intersect. But if any type of lines intersect by a line, that line is called a transversal. Here we are given, M and N are lines, and L is a transversal. So here we can understand which are the interior angles here. If we have a transversal intersect two lines, then the interior angles are 3, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, and angle 6. Also, exterior angles are 2, 1, 2, and 7 and 8. Also, we can understand about the adjacent angles on one side of a transversal, that is angle 3 and angle 6, angle 4 and angle 5. You know linear pair angles, we are already studied adjacent angles because some 180 is called a linear pair. That is, angle 1 plus 2 is 180, 2 plus 3 is 180, 3 plus 4 is 180, 4 plus 1 is 180. So here we have 8 pair of linear pair angles are here, and also vertically opposite. If two intersecting lines are given, the opposite angles at the intersecting point are called vertically opposite angles. Here 1 and 3, 2 and 4, 5 and 7, 6 and 8, these are vertically opposite angles. This was a small revision of last part we have studied, and today we have studied about transversal. So here M and N are lines and L is a transversal. So now we can study about the angles made by this transversal intersect two parallel lines. Here we are given two parallel lines, M and N, and L is a transversal. Now here so many angles we can see in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Different types of angles are here. First I am explaining about corresponding angles. What are these corresponding angles? The angles on the same side of a transversal are known as corresponding angles if both sides either above or below the lines. So we can understand which angles are corresponding in this figure. Above the line on one side, that is angle 1 and angle 5, then angle 4 and angle 8, here angle 2 and 6 on the right side, and angle 3 and 7. These are a pair of corresponding angles. And the property of corresponding angles is, if a transversal intersects two parallel lines, then the pair of corresponding angles are always equal. So we can say that angle 1 is equal to angle 5, angle 2 is equal to angle 6, angle 4 is equal to angle 8, and angle 3 equal to 7. Now, next pair of angles are alternate interior angles. What are these alternate interior angles? Already you have studied this in 7th class. That is a revision here we are taking. So the pairs of interior angles on opposite side of a transversal are called alternate interior angles. In figure, here angle 3 and 5 and angle 4 and 6, opposite side of the transversal, and the alternate angles are given. Interior means inner part of the lines. That is angle 3 and 5 are alternate interior angles, 4 and 6. Here also the property is pair of alternate interior angles are equal always. Angle 4 equal to 6 and angle 3 is equal to 5. Now alternate exterior angles means the pairs of exterior angles on opposite side of the transversal are called alternate interior angles. Here angle 1 and 7, 2 and 8. These are the alternate exterior angles. That is angle 1 is equal to angle 7, angle 2 is equal to angle 8. Here also the pair of alternate exterior angles are equal. Now next we have to study about interior angles on the same side of the transversal. What is meant by this? They are also referred to as consecutive interior angles or allied angles or co-interior angles. It is easy to say co-interior angles, that is adjacent angles on one side of a transversal. Here we can see angle 3 and angle 6 are co-interior angles, angle 4 and angle 5 are co-interior angles. What is the property about co-interior angles? Always the sum of these co-interior angles is 180 degree. That is angle 3 plus angle 6 is equal to 180, angle 4 plus angle 5 is equal to 180. We have to apply these properties in the remaining questions. We can use these applications. How to use this? In the first question, we are given in figure, find the values of X and Y, then show that AB parallel CD. How to do it? Here we are given this angle is 50 and here it is 130. What can you say about angle X plus 50? It lies on a straight line, so we can say X plus 50 equal to 180, that is a linear pair. So we can say X is equal to 180 minus 50, that is 130 degree. Here we can have X is equal to 130. So what can you say about Y? Y equal to this 130 degree. Why? Because these are vertically opposite angles. Then we can see angle X is equal to angle Y equal to 130 degree, and these are X is equal to Y. These are alternate interior angles. So by the converse of this theorem, we can say these lines AB parallel to CD. In this way, we can prove the lines are parallel by converse of the properties given. Now in the second question, we are given AB parallel to CD, CD parallel to EF, and Y ratio Z, that is angles, ratio of these angles is 3 ratio 7, then we find X, value of X. How can we find? Here in this question, we are given AB parallel to CD and CD parallel to EF. This is given. From this, we can say AB parallel EF. What is this property? Lines parallel to the same line are parallel to each other. That is AB parallel to CD and EF parallel to CD. So we can say AB parallel EF. So therefore we can say angle X is equal to Z. These are alternate interior angles. Now X plus Y equal to 180. Here we can see these are the co-interior angles. When we are given co-interior angles, sum is 180. In place of X, we can substitute Z. So Z plus Y equal to 180. But we are given the ratio of Y and Z as 3:7. Let it be equal to Y equal to 3A and Z is equal to 7A. And we can write 7A plus 3A equal to 180. That is 10A is equal to 180. So we can have A is equal to 180 upon 10. 18 degree. Now how to find X? Because X is equal to Z, we can find Z very easily. So X is equal to Z, already proved. So X equal to 7 into 18, that is 126 degree. When we multiply 18 into 7, we get 126 degree. Now here in the third question, we are given PQ parallel ST and two angles are given. Angle PQR is equal to 110 and RST is equal to 130. We can find angle QRS. How to find it? For finding this angle, we have to do a construction. That is, we are drawing XY parallel ST. XY parallel ST passing through R. It is very necessary to write passing through R. Otherwise, we can draw parallel lines at any point, at any plane, but it is passing through R. That is the important point in construction. Now, also we are given PQ parallel ST. So, PQ parallel ST and XY parallel ST. So, we can say PQ parallel XY. Why? Because lines parallel to the same line are parallel to each other. We have already studied this property. Therefore, we can say angle QRY, here angle QRY equal to PQR equal to 110 degree. These are alternate interior angles. Always when the exam, in exam you have to write the properties wherever it is necessary. When we are using any property for finding angles, it is very necessary to write the properties. Next angle SRY. How can we find SRY? We can see this SRY and angle S are co-interior angles. So we can find SRY by 180 minus 130, that is 50 degree. So we got both these angles QRY and SRY. So very easy to find angle QRS. We can subtract 50 from this 110. We get this small angle. The whole angle is 110. And this one is 50, so we can subtract these two angles. We get angle QRS equal to 110 minus 50 equal to 60 degrees. Now in the next part, here we are given if AB parallel CD and angle APQ is equal to 50 degrees and ERD equal to 127 degrees, find the values of X and Y. How to find it? First, we have to use the properties we learned. Here we are given AB parallel CD. When we are given AB parallel CD, we can take 50 plus Y, that is angle APR is equal to angle PRD equal to 127, that is 50 plus Y equal to 127. Which property is this? Alternate interior angles. These are pair of alternate interior angles. So Y equal to 127 minus 50, that is 77 degree. Now how to find X? Here AB parallel CD and PQ is a transversal, so we can say angle X is equal to 50 degree. Here this property we have alternate interior angles. Here pair of alternate interior angles are given by using this alternate interior angles, alternate exterior angles, corresponding angles, and co-interior angles. Most of the question we can solve from this part. Now here in the next question, we are given in figure, P PQ and RS are two mirrors placed parallel to each other. An incident ray AB strikes the mirror PQ at B, and the reflected ray moves along the path C and strikes the mirror RS at C, then and again reflects back along CD. Then through that angle, AB parallel CD. These lines AB and CD are parallel. So question is given this much only. Two plane mirrors are given. We are given reflected incident ray, reflected ray. Here, then how to solve this question? For that, first we have to draw normal lines, that is B perpendicular to RC, that is B and CF are two normals along the mirrors we are drawing. Now, what is the property we have studied in light chapter in science? You are already studied laws of reflection in science in 8th class, that is angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. You are already studied the laws of reflection as the incident ray, reflected ray and the normal all lies in the same plane, and also this angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. We have already studied this property. We have to use this property in this question. So when we are given E parallel to CF, already it is given by construction we can say. So angle 2 is equal to 3. Here we can see angle 2 and 3. Angle 2 is equal to 3. Why? These are pair of alternate interior angles. But by the laws of reflection we can say angle 1 is equal to angle 2 and angle 3 is equal to angle 4 by laws of reflection. Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. From all these three relations, we can see 2 equal to 3. Here 2 equal to 1 and 3 is equal to 4. So we can say all these angles are equal. That is, angle 1 is equal to angle 2 equal to angle 3 equal to angle 4. Then we can add any two. So angle 1 plus 2 equal to angle 3 plus 4. That is, 1 plus 2 is angle ABC and 3 plus 4 is angle BCD. Here you can see angle ABC is equal to angle BCD, and these are all pair of alternate interior angles. If these alternate interior angles are equal, we are given, we can say the lines are parallel by the converse of the theorem, that is AB parallel to CD. These two lines are parallel. This we had to prove in this question. Now in the sixth question, if in this figure we are given PQ parallel RS, PQ parallel RS, and angle MXQ equal to 135 degree, and this angle MYR equal to 40 degree, find angle XMY. How to find it? We are not given other things. So here we have to draw a line AB parallel to PQ passing through M. Here also passing through M is very important. We are drawing a line AB parallel to PQ passing through M. So in these two angles, we can say here 135 is given and angle XMB we had to find. How to find it? Angle XMB plus 135 equal to 180 degree. These are four interior angles. So we can say angle XMB equal to 180 minus 135 minus 45. Now angle BMY, how to find this angle? This is 40. So how we can find this angle? These are alternate interior angles. What about the property? We are already studied pair of alternate interior angles are always equal. So angle BMY equal to 40 degree. So how to find this X, M, Y? By adding these two angles, that is 45 plus 40 is equal to 85 degree. In this way, there are so many questions are given in your different books, and you can solve and find out. Sometimes you have co-interior angles, sometimes you have alternate interior angles, and sometimes you have to find this angle, this much angle, reflex angle. If it is 85, how to find this reflex angle? This reflex angle XMY equal to 360 minus 85. In this way you can find if you are asked this angle. So in the next part, we are given if a transversal intersect two lines such that bisectors of a pair of corresponding angles are equal, then prove that the lines are parallel. So here, according to our transversal, we can say angle ABC, AB, this angle and this angle are corresponding angles, and we are given D and CT as the bisectors of these corresponding angles. Now, here BE parallel to CD is given. BE parallel to CD is given. So we can say angle EBQ equal to GCS. Why? These angles are already given as corresponding angles. Suppose we are given the bisectors. Bisectors means equally divide karte. This angle, this bisector is divides this angle into two equal parts. So if they are equal, we can take, if full angle is having, we can take the half, and if half is given, we can take the twice of it. That is twice of angle EBQ equal to twice of angle GCS. What is the twice of this angle? Angle ABQ. And also twice of this angle is angle BCS. If we are seeing these angles ABQ and BCS, we can say these are pair of corresponding angles, and all these corresponding angles are equal, then we can say the given lines are parallel. Here we have to prove PQ parallel RS. So hence we are proved PQ parallel RS. So all these properties we are studied. If pair of alternate interior angles are equal, given lines are parallel. If the pair of corresponding angles are equal, the given lines are parallel. And the sum of two co-interior angles is 180 degree, we can say the lines are parallel. So by using these properties, we are solving the questions. Now, going to the next part.
Ma'am, we've got last 4 minutes left, so let's make it our last question.
Yes. So here, in this question, we are given BC parallel CD and CD parallel EF. Also, we are given EA perpendicular to AB. That means this angle is 90 degree. And if angle BEF equal to 55 degree, find the values of X, Y, and Z. We are not given these angles. How to find it? So if we are given AB parallel to CD and CD parallel EF, AB also parallel to EF, we can see AB parallel CD and EF parallel CD. So AB parallel EF. So in this, which property we are used to? The lines parallel to the same line, CD ko dono line parallel hai. So we can say AB parallel EF, lines parallel to the same line are parallel to each other. Now, here in this figure, we can say angle Y plus 55 equal to 180. Here listen, Y plus 55 equal to 180. What type of angles are here? Co-interior angles. Sum of co-interior angles is 180 degree. So we can find Y by subtracting 55 from 180. That is Y equal to 180 minus 55. That is 125. Now, here we have to find X. What is the relation between this X and Y? These are corresponding angles. So we can say angle X is equal to angle Y equal to 125 degree. These are pair of corresponding angles. Now, next we can find angle Z. How to find it? We can see AB parallel EF. So we can see this angle A and Z plus 55 are co-interior angles. So by using this power, so many properties you can use. If you are finding this angle, you can use linear term. And if this is 90, then by Agassiz property also you can find this angle. But here we are used co-interior angles. So here EAB is given as 90 degree. Next angle is Z plus 55. Sum is 180 degree. So we can say 90 plus 55 is 145. And Z is equal to 180 minus 145, that is 35 degree. In this way, here, if three two lines are parallel to the same line, we can say the lines are, the given lines are parallel to each other, and we can use the properties coincident angles, corresponding angles, or also coincident angles we are used. If we can find this angle by any property, here linear pair, angles are given, linear pair, then AB, Z is equal to 180 minus 125, we can find this angle, then by angle sum property, we can find angle Z. So, conclusion of these properties are, we are already studied about parallel lines. Two lines which do not intersect are called parallel lines. Here you can see AB and CD, and distance between these two lines are always equal. And transversal means this BE is a transversal here. What is a transversal? A line that intersects two or more lines at the distinct points are called transversal. And there are too many angles made by a transversal when it intersects parallel lines at the corresponding angles, alternate interior angles, and co-interior angles. We are already studied about these angles. So, revise this portion. And if you have any doubt, you can ask it.
Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am. And the solution was pretty much clear. You've explained each and every step about lines and angles. Thank you for being with us. Thank you for taking out time for this platform. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you to all the students as well. If you have any doubts, like ma'am said, please feel free to send your questions, your queries on our email ID, which is dth.class9@ciet.nic.in. We're wrapping up this session for now. Upcoming next is a webinar on ICT tool. And let me just tell you the topic. It's understanding doxing and ways to combat. So stay with us. Don't go anywhere. Take care. Namaste.